Hi guys, it's Miss Watts again. I'm here to talk to you about compound sentences. I told you we were going to do this work all week long. You guys are going to be experts at compound sentences by the time Friday rolls around. So, we're going to look at our book again, Jabari Jumps. Okay, so I've read a little bit to you and we've worked with some of the things in this book helping us make compound sentences. So I'm going to read just a little bit more. Okay. Jabari started to climb up and up. This ladder is very tall, he thought. Are you okay? Called his dad. Just a little tired, said Jabari. Maybe you should climb down and take a tiny rest, said his dad. A tiny rest sounded like a good idea. When he got to the bottom, Jabari remembered something. I forgot to do my stretches, he said to his dad. Stretching is very important, said his dad. I think tomorrow might be a better day for jumping, Jabari said. They looked up at the diving board together. So, let's do some thinking about that. I'm going to ask you some questions. Does Jabari want to jump off the diving board? Yes. He does want to. Remember when we started the story, he was like, I'm ready, I'm a great jumper, I'm going to jump off that diving board. So that's my next question is, why isn't he jumping off the diving board? That's right, he's scared, he's a little nervous. So we could say that Jabari wants to jump off the diving board. We know that, right? So let's write that down. Jabari wants to jump off the diving board. I'm going to prove that this is a sentence. So Jabari, right? He is a person in this book. That's a noun. I think my verb is wants. I'm going to test it. I wants, you wants, he wants. Oh, that sounds good. He wants. So this is a verb here. Wants. So I know that I have a sentence. Jabari wants. What does Jabari want? He wants to jump off the diving board. So I've got my subject, Jabari, and my predicate, wants to jump off the diving board. Now, I'm going to write another sentence about why he hasn't. So he hasn't because he's scared. So let's write that down. He feels scared. I'm going to prove this. So he, that's my noun, right? He is my pronoun for Jabari. That's who I'm talking about. Feels. I feels. You feels. He feels. That does make sense. He feels. So here's my verb. So I have two sentences. Now, I'm going to ask myself, this is an important thing to ask yourself, are these two ideas connected? Well, they are, because in the reading we've read so far that he wants to do it, but he hasn't done it yet. He's avoiding it. He's taking a tiny rest, doing some stretching, then thinking, maybe I'll do it tomorrow. So let's combine them. Now, unlike the sentences we have combined earlier in the week when we used and, these two sentences are opposites. He wants to do it and he's scared. They're contrasting. So sometimes when things are related to each other or connected, they're connected because they're opposite or contrasting. Okay? So when they do that, you can use the conjunction but. So anytime I use the conjunction but, it means that the first sentence and the second sentence are related, but they're opposing or opposite ideas, okay? So let's put them together. Jabari wants to jump off the diving board. Now remember, when I do this, after the first sentence, I need a comma. then my conjunction, but he feels scared. I did it. I made a compound sentence with the conjunction but. So what I would like you to do is I would like you to be on the hunt, put those binoculars on, and get looking for writers who use the conjunction but to combine two sentences that have contrasting or opposing ideas. I want you to put them on a sticky note. You can place it in your class if your class has a chart for conjunctions, a fanboy chart. You can put them in your notebook. So if you find a sentence, you can put it here, right? And I think writing it on a sticky and sharing it with everyone when you found one is a great idea. Okay? So I want you to look for them, right? So the last thing I'm going to ask, let's close this up, okay? I want you to post on your discussion board the answer to the following questions. When do writers use the conjunction but? And what does that tell you as the reader when you see it? All right, until tomorrow, I'll see you later. Bye!